Alrighty guys, and welcome back. Today we're going to be doing an educational informative survivor game, and it looks like we are currently playing Haddonfield. I'm going to rotate to the right-hand side and try and work on this gen. It looks like we are versing a Singularity. Now, I love playing this killer. This is probably, to me, the hardest killer in Dead by Daylight, because the amount of macro he requires is insane. However, he is very rewarding to play. He just requires a lot in order to get it to work. Now, he does have an insane add-on that people don't talk about, and it basically is whenever you pick up an EMP, which is what I'm doing right now, whenever you pick up an EMP, your aura is revealed to the killer for 6 seconds, 8 seconds with Lethal Pursuer. It is so powerful, and it allows him to basically keep you under the effect. Because you pick it up, he knows where you are, he shoots you. He activates it on you, you've got to burn it straight away. It is my favorite add-on him. By far, it's very powerful. I'm gonna try and work on the generator in the center of the map. He has pretty good prep awareness up high. I'll be honest with you. An issue that a lot of people make with this killer is they focus too much on treating him like a trapper or a hag, a preparation-based killer, and they don't play him fast and aggressive enough. Looks like an ally is being punished for running around Michael Myers' house, or in this case, Laurie Strode's house. And they're both roughly around that location. So I know where the killer is, I know where two allies are. That means one person is MIA. Look at the HUD on the bottom left. One healing, one Maya, one on a gen. He actually got away from that. That was very well done by my ally. Oh, oh, oh. He got hit on the way out. Good play by the killer. I hear my ally. I want to come over here and make sure he is not going to be under the effect, yeah? Alright, now, one of the best things you can ever do against this killer is you constantly grab the cameras. Constantly grab them. Because this killer relies on shooting you with a camera, to then shoot you with an M1, to then shoot you with a camera again. Or, sorry, an M2. There's a lot of thinking involved, and that's why the only people that play Singularity are fast thinkers normally. People that can, you know, stay up on top of it. He thought I had Saboteur! He thought I had Saboteur! The mind game! Oh! I'm holding an EMP. Oh man, that's brilliant. We'll take it. He's gonna go back and check on that for sure. He should instantly go to his camera and try and hit this guy. He's got Pop Goes the Weasel. I am not gonna hookside this gentleman, but I am gonna hit him with reassurance, yeah? Seeing the killer's intent, I'll take the save. I'll let him heal. I'm gonna clear this right now. Even though I'm not under the effect. He hit it with pop, that's okay. He'll need to come back and manually place this. He's got a lot of information over there. I'm actually probably gonna rotate to this side because chances are if he does come towards me. Okay, he's got eruption as well. He's got eruption and Pop Goes the Weasel. That's really good stability for him. He's gonna hook him in the center of the map. I'm gonna stop the regression on the gen. Remember, he can only kick a gen 8 times. After 8 times, he can't kick a gen anymore. Yup, cameras are already broken. Let's make sure we're moving in a direction where he's not going to be able to get that follow-up shot. You see how this is ready to go again? You always want to have your hands on it. This EMP is in a really bad spot where he has a camera. I got the corner just in time. I'm gonna hold it, that's okay. I'm not gonna burn it on myself. I do suffer a movement speed penalty while doing this. I need to get rid of his preparation right now, yeah? He's on a camera. I could work on the gen upstairs. I am wasting a bit of time right now. Remember, he loses his heartbeat when that happens. I can't have him hear me right now. Alright, I'm gonna keep going back to the same gen. Now, respectfully, I'm not doing much for my team right now. They're doing majority of the work. But what I am... I should have hit that. I should have walked a little bit closer and got that. What I am currently doing is I'm trying to keep the pressure in this one location, forcing him to constantly come back. Another teammate has gone down. That teammate is now on death hook. We have to be very careful of what is currently happening right now. Remember, he doesn't have pain res on that, but he does have eruption, and he does have Pop Goes the Weasel. These are important things to keep in mind. We can't get the gen done in time, but we can get a decent chunk of it done yet. Tried to take a shot on us, but he couldn't. He's looking for another angle. He should just walk over. We might get this done if you're greedy. Okay. That's really unfortunate timing. I need to go scan one of the little things on the ground and just kick the pressure up. We can hear his heartbeat. He didn't see me on anything there. He'll see my scratches if he's smart. Alright, he's going straight for that guy. I'm going straight in for the gen. The thing isn't ready to prep yet, so that's fine. Let's get straight back to work. Now, he's hit this gen 3 times. That's going to really hurt his regression, or hurt his stability. Pay attention. We could still see the killer move then. If the killer was coming towards me, I'd instantly start running to Myers' house. I'm already under his effective ability, so he can teleport about 25 meters towards me. I don't want to get shot by him, yeah? Now, if he's smart, he'd shoot this real high. Yeah. And now he can shoot over. I might be able to get away with this if I play this right. And he went for the hook instead. I'm going to greed for this. He already got eruption. I'm not going to let him hit it with pop. He will chase me after I do this. 100%. I'm going to run straight for Myers' house. I fucked up. He gets a free hit on me now. And he gets Pop Goes the Weasel. Like I said, if he's smart, he'll shoot it really high. I'm in deep trouble right now. I'm going to pay the price. Nothing I can do there. That's because I was under the effective's ability. If I wasn't under the effect, we would have been fine. Now he gets the regression on my gen through Pop. And now he's got another token of Pop just sitting there ready to go. It was a bit of a my bad in order of getting a hit with my teammate. So I'm pretty sure the killer has an add-on which increases the range of a slipstream, is what it's called, when you can infect your allies. Because I got infected through my other teammate, Felix, and unfortunately Felix had just finished his ability. And because of that, we pay the price a little bit. See, the killer is pretty far away. It's my first hook. He's just making sure the killer ain't coming back. I'll take a heal from my ally. I'm not going to run through the house. I would like to get my hands on one of the biopods. Now remember, the gen out in the middle just got hit with pop. It should be about 65% complete. I've completed 0 generators this game. I've done 0 gens, but what have I done? I've kept a bit of pressure in the center of the board. I'll be honest with you, this is one of those games where you need to acknowledge or learn to be carried. I am getting carried by my allies. At the same time, I'm trying to force the killer into an awkward situation where he's forced to constantly play around the center gen, because that's where I currently am, all the time. Gen's back at 50% right now. I'm gonna just wait here. He doesn't even turn his head, this gentleman. He should have turned his head, changed the camera, and shot me with his ability straight away, and then just let me go, forcing me to use this. Alright, gen's basically completed, and it's an indoor gen. I did 0 generators this game, and I'm walking away. This door is in an awkward spot. The other door has access to balanced landing. If we're looking at hook, I've only been hooked once. Some of my allies have only been hooked once. You can never drop an EMP on the ground. If you choose to do it, it is instantly destroyed, yeah? So never try and drop one to pick one up, yeah? Unlike Wesker or unlike Nemesis, where you can open the chest and then drop it on the ground. He's chasing one person. That person is at full health. Gonna 99 the door. Paying attention to the HUD right now on the left-hand side to see when an ally is near the other door. The killer has lost my teammate. My other player is at the door. I can see the killer is coming towards us. There's that slipstream we were talking about. Let's cleanse all of them. Other teammate looks like he has done at the door, so that is going to be an educational informative Dead by Daylight survivor game. So there's a game or example where I did no gens and we still walked away with the victory because we kept the pressure near the center of the board. If you guys enjoyed the video, make sure you hit the subscribe button. I do educational informative DBD killer and survivor content over at Twitch. If you guys want to tune into the live stream, thank you all for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the fog in the next video. Have a good one. Cheers.